Good afternoon, everyone. So my name is Patel and I'm working as a senior content developer for Meesho. And today I'll be talking about how we can achieve a phone post within the Gen Z. So the main goal when you're working with any enterprise, the main goal is the best user experience, and ultimately it should result in the gain the revenue. So let's see how this institute can help it. So 2 days back, I was just going to the tweet and I just saw this tweet. So Eric said that for the farm. So the GS that is getting downloaded faster, faster, which is compiled and executed faster, the fast way. And ultimately it results in the best user experience. But again, we are in mobile. But there are some other cities in the India where people are not able to upload high-end data. So the basically, download times matter for the low-end network and basically passing time matters for the low-end devices. So in the last line, what things will this say? That post-printing can have. So we all are aware that by chunking and by spreading the JS code, we can achieve better site performance and better performance. But in this, all this software needs something else. So let's see how we can figure it out. Apart from that, we have various combinations like high-end device, high-end network, high-end device, low-end network, low-end device, low-end network, low-end device, and internet. So the splitting will work for all the best and the extreme cases. Be it the worst, be it the best, everything. So, what is this? So basically, there might be a case where your response size may be bigger than the paid size itself, the chunks loaded by that page. So you can optimize how you can stream your response in chunks. The same way you are chunking your JS code or CSS code, you can chunk your response and deliver it to client. So let's see how we can define it. So JSON stream is basically a continuous stream of meaningful, possible, and individual JSON object chunks sent over the wire. So what I mean by this is that let's take case of Book My Show, or let's take case of any e-commerce site where there is a listing, and in that listing you get the 1000 components in the array, 1000 objects. So you stream those objects from the library. So what problem it solves? So already we have solved problems by splitting JS and CSS code. Now this is a problem of large gesture. So we'll solve it. So basically slow and couple servers. So you might be having some API call which requires to derive data onto an API call. This is one case. Another thing is, if the response that is being served by your server is really big, it can be slow and big. So for an example, if you are surfing your site, surfing your separate site, and the response that is going to be delivered is of 100 bits per instance, and something goes wrong at 70 kb, the resources and the time wasted for 70 kb is wasted, right? So again, divide the thing into small things, that will yield. Someone said pagination. So no one really wants to come on second page, right? Everyone wants to be on first page. So sometimes there are business constraints that you can't really impose pagination. In case of Book My Show, you can't paginate. Because if you paginate, that the listing of other cinemas will go on second page, third page, and that will really hamper your business. Then move out from your site. So you really can't paginate in such cases. Again, as Eddie told that larger the JS file, longer it will take to download, longer it will take to parse it. It holds true to the JSON object as well, your JSON resource. So it is larger, it will take longer to come up in part. And it will really. So the illustration is taken again from Eddie Osman's tweet. So if your asset size is greater, it will take longer to come up. So this power will multiply. And that will really hamper your performance. And really. So how it works? So basically, the same way we chunk our JSON spaces by M, we will chunk your JSON responses. So JSON responses should be chunked. Unlike JSON spaces chunking, there is a upper cap to create the JSON objects, to create the JSON chunk. So the upper cap is 64K. If there is a data beyond that, that will be converted into the next chunk. The third thing is obviously browser, because streaming is new to browser. So you have to carefully evaluate that for what all browsers you want to use. So this is an example. So the first step will show you that with streaming how it will work. The second thing is accurate. You will accurate the entire JSON response and then you will pass it. So let's see the difference. So when stream is clicked, you can see the packets are getting loaded one by one. And if the bar visible, scroll bar is visible, then it can be smaller. That means data is stable. So these are basically 108 values. This is for bounding to move, which was created last year. When accurate is clicked, what it does, that waits for the last byte to come, that aggregates all the data and pass it in the JSON format. And then after it renders the string. So demo is created using the create data and the backend of the express server. So let's see how we can implement this one. So let's see the company. So first render was quick. So basically this scenario was taken with Android and the Android device. So as soon as data for the first value was available, it rendered the data. As soon as the data for second, third, consecutively, it rendered everything. In case of accumulation, it waited for the last byte to come, accumulated it, passed it and then rendered it. So you could see the difference that it was really affecting user experience, and it really took 1.2 seconds for the first render on hand device. Let's print it out. So, this user experience is not always delivered by the computer. It has to be done with the collaboration of Sandy as well. So, we'll be making small changes in the backend as well. So, let me introduce the response. This is the Bahubali conclusion to the response. The movie was trained and this was the response for the third day. So there were 108 languages where the movie was trained in Mumbai. You can see the raw response size is 839 kb, which is more than the entire bundle of entire JS bundle of the movement website. So that is really quite scary. So sometimes what happens when you design any listing page, we are really not aware of what size of data you will be getting and handling, right? So roughly you can see that each value is of around 7 kb. Step 1 is create chunks out of your response. So the definition of this system is create meaningful and passable chunk. So this is the list and each object is meaningful and passable, right? So what I do, I iterate over the entire array and I stringify it. So I create chunk for each value. I don't know whether the code is. So basically it's simple. just iterate through over your collection of data, because normally when you are dealing with this thing, it's collection of same kind of data, right? Iterate over it, stringify it, store it from there. For example, you can store in the Notion or Analytics, or you can store it back to register, which is the key register. Now there is catchword. The upper part of the any ERP64, so it has to be digital. So the chunk which is beyond that size has to be carried over to the next. So the later function is this, the 25 function that handles that and put this code on data to the code. So this is just an example that first time we got 50K. Another is showing name, show type that makes 10K, 25K, something greater than the second showing. Now there is a print pattern which has 10 screens and each screen is showing 6 shows in a day. So that will be 60 shows a day. So that tells a lot. So the jump is 67K. So what it will do, that will divide the chunk in 64K plus 80. So there will be two chunks that will represent one line. Second thing is a stream that contains over the wire. So this is the expression. Normally what we do, we just write response dot end or response dot return to provide response to the client. But here instead of that, what can be done is whatever chunk that we created, write it down the individual of the wire. So what we did, we iterated over all the chunks, then return it on the wire, we crushed it down. And then we set the another chunk over the wire. Now, explicitly you are looking at tell that there is nothing this chunk. So in the last chunk is example, what you will do, you just tell, you close the connection. So this is how you can it. This is pretty simple. Now again, back in the so what are the changes that client is required to do is it should be able to print chunks. The header should be sent to transfer encoding chunk, interpret chunk, decode and call to the system. Let's see how it can do it. So this is a pretty straightforward syntax to characterize. File is the API which is available in code. Or in certain modern browsers, you will have to type the command in response, you get reader. And reader is basically pointing to the first chunk. So you get point to the first chunk. Then, this is string, which only read on the string. So, to read it further, readable string has to be created. And inside that, they are the start. So this is pretty thoughtful to read this thing. You get the start. Then what you do is write a recursive function that will keep reading the chunks until it encounters the last one. So inside the push function, what can be done is just read the chunks. So you want reader at first place, and here reader.read will read the chunk, and when the chunk reading is finished, in response you get two errors. The first thing is value and the other is chunk. Value is basically unsigned integer and it's basically array, and there is a dump which tells you that whether the response has finished or not. So done will be true for the last chunk. And meanwhile, you will decode the value using the text decoder converted to the JSON format. I am using the these.txt to set in the state. So as soon as chunk starts coming, you are updating the state. You are pushing the values in the state. So that after you get done, that task is done over here. The another is, so this is to form, this is to read the chunk again and again. There are certain challenges that you are facing. The first thing is this import online process. Basically, you have to process, you have to convert your data into the chunk format. So it has to be processed. So if your data is highly volatile, in that case, this won't be useful. In case of movie, for example, certain movie can be released, show times are fixed. So once your data is fixed, you can chunk it. So that will be one time process. Your business might want to attend browsers like UC browser, Ultra browser, and what part. So you'll have to check support from multiple browsers as well. And the third thing is, it might be used by your app. Maybe it's iOS, maybe Android app, or some other services that internally or company is using. So make sure you are not writing anything. So probably you might end up making another Android app. So these are some challenges that can be overcome. There are some libraries that you can check out. So these are the earlier about various and handling of flow. But preferably the implementation is really really important first. You can do it by your own.
So you have list of plugins.
you can get what are the values preferred by you according to your personal skill, and before sending the sum, you sort them and then string them over there. But make sure before sending another sum, flush it over there. So flush it over there. If you don't flush it, that will get from there.
Okay.
So in React, as is talking about memory cakes, right? So this, what are the best practices that one should follow to avoid these memory cakes? And the thing is, if someone new is jumping into React, then there is a very high chance that they'll encounter this problem and they'll miss out, right? So in that case, even seeing the task manager or activity monitor will not help any person.
Okay, so that's actually a very nice question. One of the basic things, if you want to identify memory, is keep the performance monitor on your console always on and look at the read time what it's occupying. Coming to the coding part, you assign, whenever you create a canvas context or anything, you assign something to a variable, right? Make sure the variable doesn't include all of your, React's composability. Make sure every component only handles one thing. That's way you will be sure that something other doesn't break your variables, internal state or variables context. So you have to keep everything segregated. That's a major thing when you are using with React with canvas. Just like you use React with normal as a component, it's very similar to React with canvas that you have to make everything separate. If you put in everything in a single file, chances are you might go over and it might cause a memory leak. So make sure you do that. You also that.
My question was to Vihan, like you said, like for chunking, you have to code splitting at the server side as well as the client side. Like, the chunking would be done at the client and then as well as on the server side. So, and also you mentioned like it is like you have to check the browser compatibility. So, suppose if your browser is not compatible, what is the fallback method you have opted or any suggestion from that?
So, first thing is, you are not supposed to make any changes to on client to create chunk. You will be making changes on the server to create chunks. So creating chunks is the process which is done on the server. Another thing is for the compatibility issue that you can always have a high order component that can handle the condition of this. So that will tell whether the patch is available or not. If it is not available, then you can use the by default language that you are using to patch the responses. For example, XUS you can use or normal browser patch this.
More questions from this side? Anyone?
My question was regarding the React Canvas. So you use the primitives. What are the primitives that are supported by React Canvas? And does this React Canvas component communicate with readers?
Yes, it can communicate with the readers because it's just like normal other component, but just as in React, when you render something, you render JSX, right? So the JSX actually renders to the DOM. In case of Canvas, the components which you use, so I told you about the surface component, right? Surface component is the one which actually creates the canvas, and everything is rendered on that. It's not rendered on the DOM, and that single element is rendered on the DOM. So if you check the code also, or you can visit the site, or you can check the code, you'll see only one canvas element encompasses our entire script layer. And you had another question, right? So primitive components supported by React Canvas includes text, images, and what amazing primitive component is, it supports is this view. So if you are using your normal application and you have a horizontal list or vertical list, a more performant component is readily available to you. You just have to provide the data and it will render.
And
Is React Canvas 2.0 available in React Native?
I'm not sure. That's okay, but you can do one thing which we do. So you can call, if you want to use this functionality on your app, you can create it in a web view. You can call that web view for application, because that's what we do for some of our intermediate features. We don't develop it on the native application, we directly do it on the web. So that, you know, whenever we want to push a fix, we don't have to actually release the build. You can directly.
I had a question about James. So the API I saw, there was a lot of things going on there that you wouldn't have to think about when you are trying to implement the logic of your app. So is there a wrapper on this video wrapper that HTTPS or something like that, so that you're only getting your chunks and you don't have to think about the, like, actually taking all these chunks from this and crushing data?
No, there is no such wrapper. I have encountered it. So in our case, it was very simple. It was just the idea that we want to chunk it. We want to chunk and string it. So that was the idea. We don't explore that in the library for it. But suddenly we do not want to bring libraries on a server that might increase the load and all those things. We just wanted to simple to be less. So, if I'm not wrong, is that your
question?
Thanks. Any more questions? Anyone?
Last question.
Last question. Last jump in. Who wants it?
Okay, I think.
Yeah. Thank you, Vinay. And thank you, Eva.